In this lesson, we are going to talk about events and observers. And this is the second way how we can extend or customize our Magento 2 application. There is a good official documentation about events and observers that you can find on devdocs.magento.com. And this documentation provides information on actual overview of events and observers, like events, dispatching events, how we can create configuration, observers, and so on. It's important to understand how observers are used in the Magento 2 system and how, with the help of observers, we can change or modify data or to provide some information for entities within Magento 2 application. First of all, we have to find out what is event. Event is basically a trigger within a module that allows us to listen or to subscribe to this event and create an observer class and perform some additional logic. Let's go ahead and find out how event is dispatched within Magento 2 module. There is a class that implements manager interface, and this class is responsible for allowing us or our custom classes to trigger a dispatch method and pass a few parameters. First parameter is event name, and second parameter is an array of all variables we would like to pass to our observers in order for observers to get access to these variables within observer class. So in this example, we have an array of parameters that is order. We pass this, basically it's an object and a transport. This is another example of how we can dispatch an event. And as you can see from this line, we can dispatch event without passing any additional parameters. Moreover, we can dispatch an event with event name that is dynamic. In this example, we dispatch event name based on a full action name. As we know, a full action name is basically a controller name that is used depending on what action is currently dispatched by the front controller. And in this way, we can have multiple different dynamic event names that can be dispatched, and we can attach as observers for an individual class or event. So let's say we would like to have an observer for only for customer account page, or only for, let's say, contact us page. It's all possible with this dynamic event names. This is a configuration file that is responsible for declaring observers or listeners for events. So when event manager executes dispatch method, all declared observers for a particular event name will be processed, and observer instances or objects will be executed. Additional arguments will be passed to an observer. So let's open this instance. What's important here? First of all, this is an observer. And usual naming convention, which you can find out in Magento 2 modules, is that there is a suffix for a class name with an observer word. It's not mandatory. You can use it, you can avoid it, depending on complexity of your module. Maybe you want to differentiate some classes and need to add this suffix. However, it's not mandatory. What is mandatory, in order for observer class to be an observer, this class should implement observer interface. And this observer interface is located under Magento framework event observer interface. There is only one method that has to be implemented as part of observer class implementation. This method called execute. This method returns nothing. As an argument, it receives an observer. And from this observer, we can get information or variables that were passed by an event manager. We can see that this is an implementation of execute method with observer argument and add some additional processing logic when this event is triggered. However, as you can see from this example, observer variable is not used, and it's not always the case when we need to use an observer. Sometimes, as we've seen in a layout class, in render result, there is no parameter passed as a second argument of a dispatch method. That's why sometimes observer argument is not used in observers itself. A configuration of observers or declaring an observer should be located in a separate file called events.xml. And as all scoped configuration based files, we can have three different files that contains configuration about declared observers. So there is a main DTC directory and its events.xml. And these two events or two observers are going to be triggered for all areas. And as we know, we have two areas in Magento. It's frontend and admin HTML. A good example of a module that provides not only a default events.xml file, however, a frontend based events.xml file. What it means is that this observer will only be triggered for controller action layout render before event, once dispatched, will only be triggered for frontend request. This event is also available within admin HTML area. However, since we have this events.xml file within frontend, it will not execute observer. So this is a very flexible mechanism on how we can differentiate and add some custom logic for storefront or frontend and skip this logic for admin HTML and vice versa. Or we can have a different set of observers declared for admin HTML and frontend. This configuration file syntax is the following, that we have to provide an event name or event node. I will show you an example. Event node that should contain a name of an event. And in order to find a name as, so for example, this one is assigned scene to stores after. And we can use this as event name. And then we have observer. So here we have to provide a name. Name of observer. And this name should be unique. So it's better to have vendor and module name. And a purpose of this observer. Instance. Instance, it's a class name or interface name that should be executed once this event is triggered. There is a third parameter that usually not used. It's called disabled, true or false. So we can disable this observer, or we can disable observer for a particular area, like frontend, if our observer is declared in events.xml file. And there is also a shared true or false argument that allows us. By default, it creates a shared object or object that is used every time a dispatch event logic is executed. But we can provide false if we have some sensitive state within this observer.